The following is a live presentation of CBC Sports.
Top of the 10th last night in Seattle, and with this two-run double, B.J. Surhoff puts Milwaukee ahead to stay. So here we are again, the last weekend, and the Blue Jays have still not clinched. So what's new? In 1985, the first Blue Jays pennant was clinched on Saturday afternoon, the second last day of the season, with a 5-1 win over the Yankees. 1987, the final weekend saw Toronto and Detroit, a weekend that began with the Blue Jays on top by a game and ended with Detroit winning the East. In 1989, again it came to the last weekend, nose-to-nose with the Orioles, and a clinch for the Blue Jays on Saturday. Last year, October 2nd, it took two runs in the bottom of the ninth in their final home game to clinch, with just a final series in Minnesota remaining. So this year, the Toronto tradition continues. A two-game lead with three to play. Milwaukee won't let go, so the Blue Jays need to win. Blue Jays and Tigers for all the marbles, perhaps tonight. Game one of three between the Jays and Tigers, but is tonight's the game. Good evening and welcome to another Friday night edition of Speedy Muffler Blue Jays Baseball on CBC. Let me rephrase that. This isn't just any Friday night. This is a night when a Jays victory will clinch at least a tie for the East Division crown. And later on this night, should Oakland get past Milwaukee and the Jays win here, the Jays would find themselves East Division winners by early tomorrow morning. The magic number is two, and tonight the Jays send their magic man to the mound, Jack Morris. Nights like this seem tailor-made for him. With their thoughts, here are Don Chevrier and Tommy Hutton.
And Ken, on that wild final weekend of 87, Morris was then a Tiger, of course, and Cecil Fielder was then a Blue Jay. About 18 coaches and players are still here from those two teams of 87.
Tell you what, though, Chev, a lot of players were not here in 1987. As a matter of fact, they were scattered all throughout baseball. Devon White, for instance, was in Anaheim, played for the Angels. Robbie Alomar was still playing double-A baseball in the San Diego organization. Joe Carter was in Cleveland. Dave Winfield was dealing with George Steinbrenner. Candy Maldonado was in San Francisco, and Chef John Olerud was still in college. But the Jays know one thing. If they keep winning, it doesn't matter what the Milwaukee Brewers do.
Exactly, and they have their best out there on the mound in an effort to do that tonight. Bill Gullickson, though, has been tough on the Jays. You're watching Speedy Muffler Blue Jays Baseball on CBC.